Greetings. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for waiting. As per the schedule for today's event, I'm proud to announce the start of International Day of Sign Languages, our commemorative event. I would first like to thank everyone for taking the time out of your busy schedules to be here today. So thank you. My name is Clarissa. My sign name is this. I work with World Federation of the Deaf, Regional Secretariat of Asia, and I will be your MC for today. I look forward to your support today and your cooperation with this very special celebration. It's a great day to come together, a very important day. Now, to start things off, I would like to welcome Mr. Yasonri, Director of World Federation of the Deaf, Secretariat for Asia. Welcome.
Hello, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to celebrate with you all the International Day of Sign Languages here in Japan. Thank you all for coming. In December of last year, at the 72nd United Nations General Assembly, with a joint proposal of 98 countries, including Japan, September 23rd was unanimously declared as International Day of Sign Languages. That assembly had a great significance for deaf people in that sign language, which had not been treated as a language of equal value at the global level, was finally recognized by the United Nations as equivalent to spoken languages. Since sign language is considered a language, each country or region would naturally have their own sign language, just as it has their own spoken languages. I requested the ambassadors who are here with us today, as well as representatives from Asian deaf associations, to demonstrate some of the country's sign language. At different country meetings and events attended by deaf people coming from various countries, they usually communicate for the hearing people using the English spoken language in the same manner that they'll be using international sign. For today's event, we will be communicating through international sign. Lastly, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to the Nippon Foundation and Google, who offered enormous support for this event, as well as the Japanese Federation of the Deaf for their cooperation with the planning. I would also like to wish further progress and happiness for each of us here. Let us celebrate the day together. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Shimamoto. On behalf of the United Nations, we have a special video message from Mr. Hongju Hum. He is Secretary of the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific, ESCAP.
Hello, everybody. I'm from the United Nations ESCAP, you, and I just want to congratulate all of you for the celebration of the International Day of Sign Languages.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues and friends, on behalf of the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific, I want to send my warm congratulations to all in attendance as we celebrate the first International Day of Sign Languages. I confess that today is the first time I've used international sign, and it was a wonderful experience. As you are aware, the International Day of Sign Language was proclaimed last year by the UN General Assembly with the aim to raise awareness of the importance of sign language for the full realization of the human rights of persons who are deaf. As you know, the rights of deaf communities have been ignored and even denied for many years, including their right to communicate in their own language, sign languages. Historically, sign languages were considered inferior to oral communications, and their use was prohibited by a number of countries. Using international sign today provided me with an important opportunity to consider the barriers which may be faced by persons who are deaf or hard of hearing. What if sign language was my first language and main method of communication? What would my experience be to communicate with persons who do not understand sign languages? These challenges would be tremendous, and I am sure at times I would feel marginalized and disempowered. Unfortunately, this is the experience of many. The Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disability, adopted in 2006 and effective since 2008, for the first time in history, recognized sign language and the support bilingual sign education has had throughout the world. Since then, governments around the world, both at the central and regional levels, started to legally recognize sign language as a language. ESCAP has been the regional engine promoting disability-inclusive development and disability rights over the past three decades. Currently, our regional framework, the Incheon Strategy to Make the Right Real for Persons with Disability in Asia and Pacific, builds on the convention and supports the implementation of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development by providing a disability perspective to guide member states. ESCAP's intergovernmental survey in the Asia-Pacific region has revealed that only a few governments provide sign language interpretation in key television news broadcasts. As we work towards achieving the Sustainable Development Goals, we need to transform our vision to leave no one behind into a reality for those who are disadvantaged and marginalized. Global and regional support for the use of sign languages is a crucial step in this direction. Ladies and gentlemen, ESCAP stands ready to support the cause by continuing our work towards a truly disability-inclusive Asia and the Pacific. Let's make the right real together. Thank you.
Thank you for that lovely address. Now moving on, I'd like to invite Mr. Manabu Hori'i for his address.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, hello. I am Manabu Hori'i, Parliamentary Vice Minister. Parliamentary Vice Minister for Foreign Affairs. I am Manabu Hori'i.
Yes. 皆さんこんにちは。外務大臣政務官の堀井学でございます。本日9月23日は
Today, the 23rd of September is the International Day of Sign Languages, as declared by the UN General Assembly with co-sponsors, including Japan, last December.
関係者の皆様のご尽力により手話の認知度を高めるためのイベントが関係者の皆様のご尽力により盛大に開催されますことに心からお祝いを申し上げます。日本は障害者権利条約の締結国として国内外における障害者の権利促進に積極的に取り組んでまいりました。2年後の2020年には世界中から多くの人々を迎えをし、東京オリンピックを開催をします。私自身も参加をした1998年の長野オリンピックではスキージャンプ競技のテストジャンパーとして聴覚障害者である高橋隆二さんがジャンプをされ、その姿に多くの人が大変勇気づけられました。オリンピック・パラリンピック大会のみならずデフリンピック、スペシャルオリンピックとさまざまな大会を通じ、障害の有無にかかわらず、あらゆる人々がスポーツに親しみ、夢や希望を持てる共生社会が実現することを、一アスリートとして強く期待をいたしております。日本はオリンピック・パラリンピックに向け、手話の普及を含めた障害者対策により一層取り組んでいくことに臨んであります。For the Olympic and Paralympic Games. 日本は世界の障害者の権利を保護促進するための国際協力にも積極的に取り組んでおります。これまでミャンマーにおいて手話指導技術の支援や手話通訳者の育成のための技術協力支援を実施し、障害者の権利を尊重する社会づくりに貢献しました。日本は世界の障害者の権利を保護促進するための国際協力にも積極的に取り組んでおります。最近では、キルギスタン、ウズベキスタン、アルメニア、セーシェルにおいて聴覚障害者の特別支援学校や活動支援センターの開設を進めています。障害者の特別支援学校や活動支援センターの改修、聴覚障害検査機器等の整備にかかる支援を実施してまいりました。日本は引き続き障害分野の国際協力を積極的に実施してまいります。こうした取り組みを進めるにあたって重要なことは、Nothing about us without us. An important notion when we take on these measures is nothing about us without us. 私たちのことを私たち抜きで決めないでという考え方であります。障害者の皆様が自身に関わる問題に主体的に関与できるよう、本日お集まりの皆様とともに国内外での施策を進めてまいりたいと考えております。今後も障害者の方々の権利の促進のため Let me conclude by reiterating Japan's commitment to promote rights of people with disabilities. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for that address. Up next, I'm pleased to introduce you to the ambassadors to Japan from countries around Asia. First, we have Afghanistan. Dr. Bashir Mohabbat, welcome. Next, we have Maldives.Mr. Ibrahim Yuve, welcome. And thirdly, Nepal, Ms. Prativa Rana, welcome. Can I ask each of you to sign your country and congratulations?
Hi, I'm from Afghanistan. That's the sign for congratulations. I'm from Maldives. This is a sign for congratulations in my country.
Thank you so much for that introduction. Thank you. Thank you again. Up next, I'm pleased to introduce you to the representatives from embassies in Japan, from countries around Asia. And they've been happy to agree to come here today for this special celebration. First, we have Bangladesh. Rabab Fatem. India. Mr. Brahma Kumar. Councillor. And Lao. Can you please show us your country sign and greetings?
This is a sign for Bangladesh. This is a sign for congratulations. A sign for the country India. And a sign for congratulations in Indian Sign Language. From Laos, the sign for Laos. And this is a sign for congratulations in Laos.
Thank you so much. Thank you. So following on from that, we have representatives from embassies in Japan, Pakistan, Azim Khan, welcome, Philippines, Miss Christine Margaret Milano, welcome, Singapore, our representative from Singapore, Mr. Michael Chu, welcome. I now would like you to each tell us your country sign and congratulations.
Hi, I'm from Pakistan. The sign for the country Pakistan. And a sign for congratulations in Pakistan Sign Language. The sign for the Philippines. And a sign for congratulations in Philippines Sign Language. The sign for Singapore. And congratulations in Singapore Sign Language.
Thank you so much again. Thank you. Next, we have representatives from embassies in Japan and deaf representatives from Asian countries. We have representatives from Iran, the Deaf Association. Can you please come forward? Can you please show us your country sign and congratulations?
This is a sign for Iran. And sign for congratulations in Iran Sign Language.
It's so beautiful. Thank you so much for sharing.
Hello, everybody. I would like to wish your International Day for Sign Languages.
Wow, there's so more sign language. That was fantastic. Thank you. So continuing on, we have representatives from China, Ms. Wei Luan and Mr. Yong from China Association of Deaf. Could you please now show your country sign and congratulations?
This is the sign for China and this is the sign for congratulations in China Sign Language.
Well done. Thank you so much. Next, representing Vietnam, I would like to invite Mr. Nguyen Thuan Linh and Mr. Phan Ngoc. Again, your country sign, and congratulations.
The sign name for Vietnam, and this is the sign for congratulations in Vietnamese sign language.
Thank you again. This is so inspiring to see different sign languages. Thank you for sharing. Next, let's have a few words from our deaf organisations from Asian countries taking part in the live broadcast. So it's Indonesia, Macau, and Laos. So here we have Indonesia. Hello to you all. Greetings, greetings.
Hello back from Indonesia.
So greetings from Indonesia. Thank you so much for sharing. It's great to see you. Now over to Laos. We have deaf people in Laos. Greetings to you all. Can you please show us your country sign and the sign for congratulations? There may be some problems with technology. Can you see me? Yes. Fantastic.
That's a sign for Laos. That's the sign name for the country Laos. And that's applause.
Thank you for sharing. Now moving on to Macau. We have deaf people in Macau. Greetings to you all. Hello.
Hi.
Can you please show us your country sign and sign for congratulations?
The sign for congratulations in Macanese sign language. And your country sign. That's a sign for the country, for the place, Macau. The sign for Macau.
I would now like to ask Mr. Shimamoto, the Director of World Federation of Deaf Asia Secretariat, to say a few words.
So we will be showing the sign languages for each country for the following words. Hello there, hello. From Indonesia. All right then. So in Indonesian sign language, could you please show us the sign for the word thank you?
This thank you in Indonesian.
The second word is friend.
Friend in Indonesian.
Third word is sign language.
This is sign language in Indonesian.
And the fourth word is like.
That's like in Indonesian.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Moving on. Hello there. So, could you please show us the sign for the following words? Thank you.
This is a sign for thank you.
For friend?
Sign for friend.
Great. The third word is sign language.
Sign language.
Great. The last word is like.
Like.
Wonderful. Thank you. Next, again, please show us the sign for the word thank you. So you have to sign the following words. The first word would be thank you.
Sign for thank you.
Great. Second word would be friend.
Friend.
The third word is sign language.
Sign language.
Great. The fourth word is like.
Sign for like.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
That's fantastic to have a live broadcast in different countries. And it's all from Asia. It was so beautiful to see. I now call upon Professor John Ma of International Christian University to deliver a commemorative speech under the theme Sign Language and Society. Welcome.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Kokusai Kiristo Kyo Daigaku, John Maha. Yes. And congratulations, everyone. Thank you for inviting me. Today, it is an honor to speak to you. I want to discuss language. In Japanese, we say gengo, and in particular, sign languages. In Japanese, we say shua gengo. And I will discuss their characteristics and their connection. Human language is unique. Language uses grammar and vocabulary to express thoughts and ideas. The capacity and creativity of human language is endless. Animals and insects, such as whales and bees, have wonderful communication systems. However, those systems are closed. They're not creative. Animal communication is fixed. If you look at 100 honeybees today, they have the same communication as 100 honeybees 20 years ago, 100 years ago. Because of the creativeness of human language, it changes. It changes according to place. It changes over time. Language is the basis of our human identity. Languages are alive. Last year, I was sitting in a cafe in London, and next to me, a family was signing. Maybe this family was planning the day. They were talking, the children were arguing and laughing. And they were using British Sign Language, BSL. Although I can read a dictionary in British Sign Language, I cannot sign in BSL. Language is a living thing, more than dictionaries. As we know, there is a myth among people that sign language is universal. You know, and I know, that it varies from country to country. Laos sign language, Persian sign language, Indian sign language. Each language is different. Well, there are about 6,500, 7,000 languages in the world. There are big languages, such as Chinese and French. There are small languages, like Irish and Scottish, Gaelic. Where I lived in Scotland, Scots, Irish. Among the world's languages, there are 140 sign languages. Linguists all over the world recognize that sign languages are just ordinary languages. There are many organizations, many colleges and universities, research institutes in the world. If you knock on the door of any institute in the world, every expert will reply in the same way. Yes, of course, Malaysian Sign Language is a language. Yes, Vietnamese Sign Language is a language, and so on. In fact, to ask the question is rather embarrassing. It's like asking a Chinese or a Japanese schoolteacher, excuse me, is kanji really a writing system? Can I believe you? Really? Or asking my school teacher in a classroom in Dublin, excuse me, is Irish really a language? Is it different from English? Why do people think that this language and that language are identical? Well, misunderstanding about language and languages does not come from bad intention. People are not bad people. Misunderstanding is the result of a lack of knowledge about language, what language is. Okay, so how can we answer such questions like, is X really a language? Here is a quiz. Think about your language or languages, the languages you use. And here are 8 questions about your language. Answer yes and no, or yes or no. You can take a memo. Are you ready for the quiz? Okay. Let's start. 1. Grammar. Does your language have rules? Does your language have grammatical rules? I do not mean a physical grammar. I mean a set of rules to communicate. 2. Does your language recognize correct usage and incorrect usage? Your language has some kind of standard. 3. History. Does your language have a history? Has your language developed over time? 4. Does your language have a community? Do the speakers of your language form some kind of community? 5. Culture. Does your language have a culture? Does your language have songs, poetry, storytelling, theatre? 6. Diversity. Does your language have some variation, such as regional dialects, a city dialect, a country dialect, young people's language, old people's language, schoolboy, schoolgirl language? Yeah? 7. Identity. Does your language give you identity? Does it help you develop as a person? Does it give you some self-concept? And 8, autonomy. Is there a feeling among your language that your language is somehow different from other languages? It has autonomy. How was the quiz? If you checked yes to these points, then bingo. Your language really qualifies as a language. Oh, but do you think something is missing from this quiz? Where is written language? I did not mention written language. Some people think that because sign language is not a written language, then it's not a language. Well, of course, this is mistaken. In fact, if you look around the world, before the 20th century, most people in the world did not use written forms. In other words, literacy, universal literacy, really arrived in the 20th century. Most languages of the world are traditionally oral languages. So universal writing is a modern phenomenon. Until recently, people in Europe could not read or write. Literacy was for the elite. Literacy was for a minority. Therefore, to say that sign language does not have a writing system, so it's not a language, that view is illogical. Let me now talk about the status of sign languages. Are sign languages minority languages? Well, for the past 30, 40 years in Europe and Asia, we have been discussing the concept, the idea of minority languages. In the 1970s, around the world, there was some doubt or suspicion about the term minority. Many people felt that the term minority is ambiguous, unclear. Actually, I speak Irish. It is a minority language. And I am not happy about the term minority language either. What do you think? Well, the European Union has been trying to create a new framework, new terminology, perhaps different from the term minority. And the EU is very interested in promoting the status of sign languages and other languages, different from the big national languages. Therefore, the European Union developed the term lesser-known languages. Lesser-known languages. And in 1982, they set up a special office for lesser-known languages in Dublin, in Ireland. This was the Bureau for Lesser Known Languages. In 2010, this office changed its name. It was replaced by another name. Here it is. European Language Equality Network. Please note that phrase, language equality. Now it's changed. Well, we need a good framework to describe the language situation of each country. And the European Union is trying to make a new framework. We need a good framework to describe multilingual society, multicultural society. And we must encourage all citizens to share the same concepts, to share the same terminology. We need all citizens of the world to see the languages around them. Each country, I think, needs to review its national census to reflect the language diversity of all citizens. And here I have two proposals. Most censuses are based upon the concept of monolingual society. But we need a national census that reflects bilingual society. We need a national census that reflects language diversity in the nation. Why? Because a national census is a barometer of language diversity and language freedom. So let me give an example of questions in a census. And here are some questions from the National Census of Canada and the National Census of Ireland. Here are the questions. What languages do you use at home? What languages do you use at home? Second question. What languages do you use at work? What languages do you use at work? Third question. What is your mother tongue? What is your mother tongue? And here we have a possibility of one mother tongue, two mother tongues, three mother tongues, four mother tongues. Okay. And the fourth question, how well do you speak your languages? You rank the fluency of your languages. Well, it is, honestly speaking, it's easy to insert good questions. We have many models for good questions in national census. And in the European Union, there are many versions of questions. The results can clarify many things about the languages of citizens. Such questions raise awareness about the existence of sign languages and other languages. A national census which shows language diversity respects citizens. It respects their languages. My second proposal here is that governments create an office for multiculturalism and multilingualism. And the job of this government office is to actively promote languages, actively promote the various cultures that we have. Canada has such an office. And Canada promotes the sign languages of Canada and other languages. And so, can we establish such a government office to support and promote multiculturalism, to support multilingualism, to support sign language and other languages? I will finish there. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for that presentation. We will now move on to a panel, and so you'll hear further information about that. So for the various the ambassadors here today from Timor-Leste, thank you for your attendance today. Thank you to the ambassador. We had a live broadcast with the various signs of countries and congratulations. So now we have four people here. And I'd like to have them come up stage again.
Okay, so at this point, we have different country representatives from the deaf associations. They are all deaf. And again, we will be asking them the sign, their country signs, for the following words. The first word would be, thank you.
There's a sign for thank you in China, in Iran, Japan,
arigato,
and in Vietnamese sign language.
Wonderful. Thank you. The second word would be friend.
Friend in China sign language. In Iran sign language. In Japan sign language. And in Vietnamese sign language.
Great. The third word would be sign language.
The sign in China sign language. Iran sign language. Japan sign language. And Vietnam sign language.
Wonderful. The fourth word would be like.
Like in China sign language, Iran sign language, Japan sign language,
ski,
and Vietnam sign language.
Thank you for that. This is so exciting to see various signs from different countries. Up next, we have some remarks from Google. Welcome. Welcome, Yoshitaka.
Studio Tokyo. Welcome. お会いできて嬉しい。
I am very happy to meet you all.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you very much for coming today. My name is Yoshitaka Sugihara, Head of Public Policy at Google in Japan. We are very glad and honored to have World Federation of Deaf Regional Secretariat Asia and Nippon Federation hold this memorable first anniversary for International Day for Sign Languages. As you may know that Google's mission is organize the information and make it accessible and useful. And also, we believe that our product is for everybody, not just for the elite, but for everybody. Every our products, like search, map, and YouTube, AI, that is for everybody, especially for the YouTube. Here, this is for the YouTube studio. This studio for YouTubers. Have you ever heard of the YouTubers? YouTuber is the creators who expressed themselves to the globe. they are ordinary people, not actresses or actors or the celebrities. They are the same like us. Those people create, and also those people try to express themselves to their friends, to the families, to the people who are beyond themselves by YouTube. This space is to encourage those people to connect the people. So we are very much happy to have all of you here in YouTube studio in Tokyo. The Google believe that our technologies is helping people to connect, helping people to make their lives easier and more happy. And as I mentioned that, embracing people to do something who really want to do something. So this is the one of the good opportunities to use the YouTube for the people who have the challenges to connect to their friends, to the globe. And lastly, I'd like to tell all of you that is our colleagues, as we call the Googler, in Mountain View, who has the challenges for the hearing, the deaf, is put on the captions for our live streaming. Our live streaming is connected to everywhere, globally, today. So, lastly, I really would like to thank you, all of you here, and please enjoy today's this ceremony. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Yoshitaka. Okay, at this time, I'm pleased to welcome Mr. Takashi Shuzaki, a very well-known actor and director in Japan, and he will present a special performance today. Welcome. Here we are. Welcome. What a fantastic Sorry for the silence, but the performer is actually going to get changed, so we'll be back very shortly.
Okay, a round of applause for that. That was a really wonderful performer from Japan, and we are glad to have watched that, so thank you so much. So moving on, we'd just like to have a little chat about the World Federation of the Deaf Regional Secretariat for Asia, and we have the Deputy Director together with me just to share with you some information. All right, then.
I think it's important that you know what we actually do here in Asia. So I will ask some questions and let's see how we go. My first question, WFD Regional Secretariat of Asia, how many ordinary members are there?
In the WFD Regional Secretariat for Asia, we have ordinary members in 17 countries.
Fantastic. So those ordinary members, which are the countries?
We have Japan, Macau, Korea, China, Iran, Pakistan, Nepal, Philippines, Malaysia, India, and Indonesia. Korea, Thailand, Macau, close to Macau, Hong Kong. Yes.
Pakistan,
I think
Bangladesh,
Afghanistan.
So in total, we have 17 ordinary members. So how many of them?
Well, in the future, I hope to have one more member. Vietnam, Laos, and those two countries have not yet joined us. And I hope that there would be more countries to join us. Roughly around the Asia-Pacific region, we have about 50 countries. But those who have who are members are below 17. So I'm hoping that there would be more ordinary members in the future for WFDRSA.
I do have to agree. There's many of them who are not members, and thinking about human rights, it's really important that we have those members.
Right. And we wish to inform everyone that within the Asia-Pacific region, we do know that in Asia, the culture in terms of economic exchange, we have persons with disability, especially the deaf people within the Asian region, dealing with education concerns. Do they have 100% access to education? Do they have sign language instruction? So So that's the question I would like to ask, together with Clarissa, that I hope that there'll be more deaf schools who will be using sign language. What's the percentage of the schools
using sign language? I would have to say that the level of education is not so good.
And that is because, what's the reason for that?
We do have sign language teaching, but it's not at that level. It's not on par.
Well, right, it's not at par, but I'm hoping that as we have more and more deaf people, we do hope that they would be learning sign language more as the primary language. And just like myself, who was born deaf, the first language that was taught to me was sign language? No, it was spoken language. And that was the first language that I was exposed to. And I have no knowledge at all about a sign language. And so I learned spoken Japanese, oral Japanese. And that's it. So right now, as I grow a lot older, this seems to be more complicated, and somehow it doesn't quite fit in. Is it the same thing with you?
Just a small addition to that. I know right now we've been advocating quite a fair bit with the Macau government, so we're hoping that we'll see improvements in the years to come. I have one question for you. We have WFDRSA, but what about youth? What's their participation?
Right. We wish to inform and encourage everyone, especially within the Asia-Pacific region, to have more deaf youth in terms of to encourage more deaf youth to be involved. At the same time, within the Asian region, we hope that it's very important for them to be involved in the community and to interact, to have social interaction with each other, not only virtually, but hopefully in person. And so I hope that in Asian region, we have very few interactions within our deaf people, the youth deaf people, and we hope to have more interaction amongst them and to develop a stronger tie, a stronger bond within the individuals, especially in when we're talking about sign languages, so we encourage further development.
Thank you for that. As you know, that's really important, and we need to empower. So that's so true. Thank you for that. Now, my final question. This year, WFDRSA, what are the activities? Can you demonstrate what has taken place?
It's very crucial to have to encourage a lot of activity, especially for the hearing. They have developed the spoken languages, oral languages, but in terms of sign language, we have people who are working closely together, and we have to make sure that we are recognizing the importance that interpreters play. These interpreters will help bridge the hearing and the deaf world, but unfortunately, there seems to be a disconnect. And so a lot of times, the deaf people are set aside, and so we need to work on developing our interpreters, and hopefully they could be at par in terms of the hearing people. So we need to develop and train more and more interpreters within the region.
Thank you for that. Now we have two interpreters here. We have one from the Philippines and one from Malaysia. And also we have a representative from WASLI who's been training as well. So just to let you know that we have three IS interpreters here.
That's right. We need to really go deeper into having more interpreters training. And I know it might prove to be a challenge at this point, but hopefully as we develop we're dealing with different languages, English, Japanese, Chinese. We need to have more sign language interpreters trained as well, so that we need to respect that and also to honor that. And as part of recognizing our human rights, it is a must that we have to have access to interpreters. This is a very crucial element that we need to have more training for our interpreters.
And one more activity that I think you should share?
That's a good question. In terms of interpreters' training, it is also important, it is imperative that the government should provide support, that the government should not forget the crucial role that they play, which means that it should be made official, that sign language should be made official, and that the role of the interpreter should be recognized in their countries.
Thank you so much. And can you talk a little bit more about the equality, about recognition of sign language?
Right. The United Nations Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities have already ratified that in each country there should be a legislation recognizing sign language, and we do hope for each member country to actually uphold that, because that is part of our human rights. We need to have a legislation so that deaf people would be able to use the sign language. And so please, we are asking the government to take on the responsibility to ensure that recognition of the sign language is included in the laws and legislations, so that oral languages as well as sign languages could be treated equally.
I do have to agree, and hopefully many of the representatives here will also support that idea. It's really important that we do have recognition, and it is a statement from the United Nations. So we need to bear that in mind.
Right. Globally, each country, the whole world over, whether they are hearing, you know, we come from a very diverse background all over the world, and we have deaf people, persons with disabilities should come together and work hand in hand. And it's really, really important, and we're hoping to see more progress in the future and a stronger Asian community.
I do agree that sign language is are vital, but also technology, because then you can have access to different sign languages around the world. And having live broadcasts is really important. So thank you so much.
That is right. Technology is very important in providing support at the same time that we would like to have them access to universities, to education, using sign language, and not only for the deaf people, but for people with disabilities in general, but because right now there are very few, and we're hoping to increase that in the future.
That's so true. Thank you for that information, and hopefully you get a better understanding, and hopefully representatives here today will give more support. Thank you. Just to let you know that our recent performance by Mr. Shuzaki, that was not his final performance. He will, in the second act, have another performance. And I'm sure you will enjoy that. So, I hope that you've enjoyed the first half of today's celebrations. We now have a 30-minute intermission, and we'll be back here at 3 p.m. Thank you. See you shortly. Hello again. Welcome back to part two of International Day of Sign Languages. My name's Clarissa, and this is my sign name. I work for the World Federation of ADEF Regional Secretariat in Asia. First up, I would like to invite Mr. Kazuhiro Yoshikura, Executive Director of the Nippon Foundation. And they are hosting the event alongside World Federation of ADEF. Thank you. Welcome.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
I am
Kazuhiro Yoshikura of Nippon Foundation. This is a commemorative first International Sign Language Day. I would like to welcome you all to this event, especially the ambassadors of different countries and also the people from the embassies and also the representatives of the deaf communities of Asia. And also I'd like to thank the Governor Hirai of Tottori Prefecture and other guests who are here with us today. Thank you very much indeed for coming. Also, I'd like to thank Google for hosting this event, Mr. Peter Fitzgerald, who is a representative of Google Japan. At Nippon Foundation, we have been engaged in activities to make sign language a language. One of the changes happened in 2013 in October. Tottori Prefecture started the ordinance or bylaw about the sign language. This movement was followed by 186 different municipalities. All of them established the sign language ordinances. And Tottori Prefecture started this movement. Tottori is famous for their crafts and also stars, but I myself call Tottori Prefecture as a holy land of sign language. Now, as for the wave of making the sign language one of the languages, this is a major step, but this is only a first step. Those native sign language users, we would like to make it possible so that those native sign language users will be able to make different choices in their lives. We would like to create such society. Having education in sign language and working using the sign language and to make a living using the sign language. We would like to create such society. Especially in making the livelihood using the sign languages, we would like to make it possible so that the community and the cities and towns, as well as people in those environments, support each other using sign languages. So in order to create such society, we will continue to make efforts, but we need your cooperation to do so. And for that, we also hope your prosperity and strong support for this movement. And with that, I'd like to end my greetings. And thank you very much for coming. And congratulations to you all. Thank you.
Thank you to the Nippon Foundation, and thank you so much for your support with this celebration today. Next, I would like to invite Mr. Shinhi Hirai, who's the Chair of the Governor's Assembly for Promotion of Sign Languages, Governor of Tottori Prefecture, here to say a few words.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
私の名前は平井真嗣と申します。
Shinji Hirai.
Thank
you very much, and it is nice to meet you all. Now, I am also acting as the governor for Tottori Prefecture. 47 prefectural governors work throughout the nation, and all of us are now participating in the Governor's Assembly for Promotion of Sign Language. I am also acting as the chair for this assembly as well. This is International Sign Language Day, and this is the first time we are commemorating this through this event, and I would like to extend my heartfelt congratulations to all of you. I do believe that on this day, in many parts of the world, we are all celebrating this day. Times have greatly changed. And this change is quite important, I believe. I myself, when I was in university, I encountered sign language for the very first time. In 1981, there was a global convention, and I attended as a sign language volunteer. I was in charge of the Thailand team. There were challenges back then. One was communication. I wanted to speak in English. However, I found it very difficult to express myself in English. But then I suddenly realized the members from Thailand were a group of disabled persons, and so they were using sign language. And I learned briefly sign language on that occasion. I started to use sign language. And I realized that communication was very smooth after that. Sign language is a beautiful language. I do hope that this sign language can be used by many. And by doing so, I believe society will become a much more better place to live in. 47 of the prefectural governors are acting to promote sign language throughout the nation. We do look forward to your support, and we want to further extend our activities as well. As Helen Keller once said,
"Keep your face to the sunshine, and you cannot see the shadow." あなたの顔を
Always make sure that you face the sunshine. And by facing the sunshine, you cannot see the shadows.
私たちは一緒に新しい時代を作りたいと思います。
I will need to join hands to create a new era. So let us all work hard together. Once again, congratulations.
Thank you for that address. Thank you again. Now moving on. We'd like to hear from Fushisaburo Ishino, President of Japanese Federation of the Deaf, who has been in cooperation in making today's event in Japan possible. Welcome.
こんにちは。ただいまご紹介いただきました全日本ろうあ連盟理事長の石野でございます。
This is the president of Japanese Federation of the Deaf.
昨年12月、
Thank you very much
国連におきまして、
the introduction. The General Assembly of the United Nations declared September 23rd the anniversary day of the establishment of the World Federation of the Deaf as an international day of sign languages in December 2017. After a year, we are celebrating the first ever special day today.
ご出席いただいた皆様とともに、
the Japan Federation of the
Deaf, 記念すべきイベントが我が国で開催できますことを、全日本ろうあ連盟といたしましても大きな喜びでございます。我が国におきましては、まだまだ手話言語についての認知が十分な状況ではございません。
We continue our best efforts on the daily basis for the establishment of the Sign Language Act and the Information and Communication Access Act, as well as for the expansion of the telecommunication relay service.
さらなる努力、活動を推進してまいります。2年後、東京におきまして、オリンピック、パラリンピックが開催される、この時期を控え、国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンション、様々な施設の建設が進められております。国内におきましては、インフラタワーマンまた権力として発揮できるよう、障害者自らが当事者の立場でさまざまな場面におき情報発信をする、また理解を広げていくとともに、共生社会の実現に向けての一翼を担える努力というものが求められる状況にあります。今後世界ろうあ連盟アジア地域事務局とともに密接な連携を構築しながら、アジアにおける福祉の向上発展につながるよう結束して取り組んでまいる所存でございます。結びに、本日主催であります世界ろうあ連盟アジア地域事務局、また日本財団の今後のますますの発展をお祈りするとともに、皆様方のご健勝とご多幸を祈念いたしまして、皆様方のご健勝とご多幸を祈念いたしまして、私の挨拶とさせていただきます。ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for that lovely address. Now you can see on this screen our invited guests. We have Noi Yass, Health, Labour and Welfare Ministry. We also have Kiyoshi Shiba, United Nations Information Centre.Mr. Masao Watanabe, the National Research Association for Sign Language Interpretation, and Ms. Eiko Uguro, Japanese Association of Sign Language Interpreters. So thank you to all of those. We also have a congratulatory telegram.From Mr. Hiroshi, Union of Diet, members for promoting UN Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities. Up next, we have a panel discussion. So this is the exciting part. We are pleased to present a panel discussion based on the theme Sign Language and Communication. So first up, we have Mr. John Ma.
こんにちは。世界ろうあ連盟事務局の副事務局長からご紹介がありました。
And thank you very much for the introduction.
すいません。改めまして、ただいまご司会の方から紹介していただきました。
As was just introduced.
全日本ろうあ連盟の理事であります石橋と申します。
My name is Ishibashi.
今回世界ろうあ連盟のアジア地域事務局副理事務局長のクラリサからパネルディスカッションの司会という大役を仰せつかりました。
And I have been designated as the moderator
for this panel.
Thank you very much for this honor.
それではパネリストの方をご紹介いたします。
Now, let me introduce the panelists for this panel discussion.
登壇いただけますか？
If the remaining panelists can step up to the stage, please, Mr. Hidai as well as Mr. Ishino, please.
ただいまよりパネルディスカッションを
始めさせていただきます。テーマは、サイン
ランゲージ。サ
インランゲージ。サインラン
ゲージ。サインランゲ
ージ。サ
インランゲ
ージ。サインランゲージ。サインランゲージ。Once again, the theme of this panel discussion is sign language and communication, so let us begin. In the first part of today's session, we heard from Professor Maha, and let me reintroduce him.
Maha 先生は国際キリスト教大学の教授であられ、
He is a professor of linguistics at the International Christian University.
手話が言語たるゆえんについて、
Sign language
お話をお願いいたします。
Is a language and why that's the case. He will be explaining.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
まあ、まず、指摘したいことは、
The first, I'd like to point out,
手話言語は社会における
language is
言語の、多様性、
It represents
また文化の、
diversity of the language and diversity of culture. And such, it is an important component of diversity. Important issue is thatWe tend to have, or regarding the sign languages and our language life, it challenges how we can raise the awareness of people on these topics. The ordinary people going through their
言語についての
education system, especially、
まあ、
compulsory education system, and it is surprisingly little、
皆さんどうですか、
average people learn about languages. And at school, have、まあ、you learned sciences?、
苦労して
I'm sure many of you struggled to study.Physics and other science lessons. So, high pressure, low pressure, what they are, and how the sun moves or we move around. And you understand what are those phenomena? So, in our educational system,
理科の知識
we gain the basic knowledge of sciences. But both in Japan and other countries alike, regarding our language life, the education teaching of that is very little, or if not none. But in our language environment, there is a topic of language ability development for children, and language diversity, and language and nationalism, and language right, and language discrimination, and language and local dialect, the relationship between the language and dialects. These are important topics.
But
language education on those topics are very few and rare. When it comes to sign languages, and when we were discussing its legal framework and rights, I believe there are three perspectives we can apply, possibly apply to look at languages. The first, languages as a problem, or second one is language as right. And the third one is language as a resource, that is, by capturing the diversity of languages in society, in order to capture that, which philosophy is called for? That's something we have to think.
Language as a problem.
The first approach of language as a problem. In the past, people with bilingualism were sometimes considered as a problematic people. So they were forced to assimilate in the policy. So the language diversity is costly or cumbersome, and it will have extra burden on the lingual brain, and people who speak both languages are inferior. So the main language of a nation should suffice for everybody. And your mother tongue is not really needed in order to live and carry out the daily life. That was a perspective very common in the 19th century.
And
indeed, even now, we often come across with this kind of perspective.
Language as a right.
And the second one is the language as right. In the 20th century, the personal rights and contrary to the personal right emphasis, there is a need and right to maintain the one's language. And as was mentioned earlier, the UN Declaration of Human Rights mentions or touch upon this type of right. And if you are not aware of or understand this kind of right, and one could be very intolerant, And thus you may be inclined to suppress people's rights. And if the government doesn't recognize the diversity of the language through its legal basis, and this is typically the problem.
Language as a resource.
And the third one is the concept of language as a resource. And here, language is also considered as asset. As an asset. And language enriches our life. And language diversity or linguistic diversity just like, well, bridges the societies and communities, just like economy and industry and social interactions too. And when the language is taken up as right, sometimes governments become quite sensitive. But language does represent the harmony and tolerance, social tolerance, and promote them. To summarize, learning two or more languages leads to higher level of educational achievement, and also can make a person more happier citizen, and also make a better human resource for the economy as well. And that's what I believe. Maybe I should stop now, for now.
Thank
you very much, Professor Maha.
Next. 手話を広める知事の会会長である
The President of Governors Assembly to promote the sign language.
知事の平井俊二様、鳥取 Prefecture、お話をいただきます。平井知事は日本で初めて手話言語条例を制定した
鳥取県の知事でもあります。In Tottori Prefecture.
手話言語条例制定による手話言語の市民への普及等に向けた政策についてお話をお願いいたします。
Governor will explain
the activities. 平井様よろしくお願いいたします。
Governor Hirai.
よろしくお願いいたします。
Thank you very much.
私たちは鳥取県というところなんですが、どこにあるか非常にわからないというふうに多くの方々がおっ
しゃいます。 know where the Tottori Prefecture is located.
実は、マハ先生ですね。
Professor Maha.
先ほど伺ったんですけども、
I asked him.
島根大学で教えていただくことがあったそうです。昔ですね。その島根と私どもは実は隣り合わせでございまして、私どもですね、実は T シャツを作りました。
We created a T-shirt.
鳥取県は、
which says the Tottori Prefecture.
鳥取は島根の右側です。
Is on the right-hand side of Shimane Prefecture.
左側です。
Oh, sorry, the left-hand side of Shimane Prefecture.
T シャツを作りまして。
That's what the T-shirt says.
で、島根さんの方はですね。
So Shimane Prefecture.
島根は
says that
Shimane 右側です。
Is on the right-hand side of Tottori Prefecture.
いう T シャツを。
So they also created a T-shirt.
これをお土産として実は売ってるんですけども。
Those T-shirts are sold as gifts.
結局二つとも買ってもですね、どこにあるかよくわからない。
You still don't know where they are.
まあ、そういう、鳥取県であります。
So that's what Tottori
まあ、このスライドに、ございますのが、これが、まあ、手話言語条例が制定された時の写真でございます。あの石橋さんもいらっしゃいます。
石橋
さんもこれで大変にご尽力いただきました。また日本財団の吉倉さんはじめとして多くの皆様にも大変にお手伝いをいただきました。医師の理事長はじめろうあ連盟の皆様もご協力をいただいたわけであります。そのご尽力のおかげでこれが出来上がったところでございました。次お願いします。手話を広める
知事の会でございます。
これは2年前に創設をいたしました。そして去年この手話を広める知事の会すべての47人の知事が加入をいたしました。今例えばですね、県職員の研修を行ったり、
We have a training activity and also we organize forums to promote the sign languages. We have various activities. Next slide.
これは手話言語条例ができた後、どういうようなことを私たちがやっているのかということであります。まあ、例えば議会がありますけれども、これを中継をしているときに手話通訳が来ます。また私が記者会見を行います。その時も手話通訳が来ます。それから手話の勉強会、これ社会の中でありますとか、あるいは職場でありますとか、あるいは地域で手話学習会、
現在までの間に6000人をレベルで
この手話の勉強会参加をいただいているところであります。次お願いします。
Next slide.
まあこれは教育に関することであります。手話について大切なことは学校という場であります。もし子どもたちが手話を覚えれば20年経って、あるいは30年経ってこれから手話を分かる人たちがどんどんとこう増えてくることになります。そうすると社会は大きく変わるわけですね。で、私どもではこういう手話のハンドブックを作りました。まあ、この例えば入門編でありますとか、あるいは応用編、これをすべての学校にこれを配布をいたしまして、それで使っているわけです。子供たちは今手話を学んでいます。
So children are learning sign language.
手話部という、
so they have, for example, the club or team of sign language.
Or they have started
the sign language as a part of their curriculum.
まあこれは手話をのためのまあ、技術ですね。
The use of technology to promote sign language. I'd like you to look at this. This is a remote sign language interpretation service. So she's trying to check on the time of the bus. So as you can see in the tablet, we have a sign language interpretation service so that the communication can be facilitated.This way.
じゃあ次お願いします。
Next slide.
これは手話を使いまして、
so using sign language,
それで観光の案内をする、
like、
そういうビデオでございます。
Instruction or guide.
聞こえない2人の女性が、so、those
two people are deaf,
手話で案内をします。
And, they are being guided with sign language.
手話ガイドによる鳥取県おすすめ観光ガイド。妖怪ワールド満喫水木しげるロード2人の観光ガイド。
皆さんこんにちは。
小田さん、
栄港市はゲゲゲの鬼太郎の作者漫画家水木しげる先生の ふるさとです。
西山さん、
ここには全長800メートルの通りにゲゲゲの鬼太郎でおなじみの妖怪ブロンズ像が立ち並ぶ水木しげるロードがあります。
鬼太郎、目玉の親父、ネズミ男のブロンズ像、
妖怪ワールドが満喫できる大人気スポットです。
そんな水木しげるロードのおすすめ情報はこちら。
まあ、こんな風にですね、私たちは video, 聞こえる人も、
those people
またあの聞こえない人も
can hear,
まあ旅行を楽しめるように、そういう
環境を整えていきたいと思っております
。次お願いします。
We like to create such environment.
まあ、これは手話パフォーマンス甲子園であります。どうぞご覧ください。
Like you to look at the video.
全国高校生手話パフォーマンス甲子園は全国で初めて手話は言語であると高らかに声を上げた鳥取県で毎年開催されている高校生による手話パフォーマンスの祭典です。平成26年の初開催以来、毎年多くの感動を生んできました。手話を使った歌にダンスに演劇にコントなどなど、さまざまなパフォーマンスで手話表現を競い合います。
まあ、こんな風に、私たちは手話を広めるために
We are trying to promote the sign language and we have various activity to do so. So high school students are showing the performance which is quite moving. The princess Kako actually came to see this event and she gave us some words.And she once read a poem. Young people working together.
そうする舞台からですね。
And from the stage.
心が伝わってくるという。
The heart-to-heart communication was realized. That was a kind of a poem that the princess gave us at this event. Next slide.
これがいよいよ。
So in October, on the 7th of October, we will have this competition. So I would like to invite all of you to come to Tottori. Next slide. So I hope to see you in Tottori. So here on the slide, this mountain, this is called Daisen Mountain. And the other day,Princess Mako came to visit this mountain. And Tottori is famous for its sand dunes. There are many tourist landmarks. And also, we are famous for our pears. The name of our pear is Shinkansen, which means bullet train.
And for us,
there are no train, Shinkansen or bullet train stations in Tottori Prefecture, so we named the pear instead as Shinkansen. We are also famous for beef, very delicious beef, especially also the snow crab is in its season. The fishing for the snow crab started in Tottori. So we are thinking of changing our prefecture's name from Tottori to Kanitori prefecture. So please, I would like to welcome all of you to Kanitori prefecture instead of Tottori prefecture.
はい、ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much, Governor.
平井県知事、ありがとうございました。
So once again, thank you, Mr. Hidai.
次に最後になりましたが、全日本ろうあ連盟の理事長の石野藤三郎より、Mr. Fujisaburo Ishino. 日本における手話言語の普及理解の取り組みの紹介と手話言語法制、手話言語法制定運動の取り組みについてお話をお願いいたします。
全日本ろうあ連盟の会員現在1万9000人ほどおります。 We now have 19,000 members of the Japan Federation of the Deaf, and there were many, many members that wanted to attend and see this event. But the fact that this event was held in Tokyo, many members could not visit. So via YouTube, we are broadcasting this event live to many, many venues throughout Japan. And we are hearing from the participants throughout the country that they are seeing and viewing this event via their smartphone. Now, as Professor Maha just mentioned as well, and I briefly talked with him over lunch as well, he is very fluent in Japanese. And 5 years ago, I understand that he learned sign language as well, so he is... He possesses the talent of sign language as well. He was very modest about it, but I know that he is very fluent in sign language as well. Governor Hirai, we have known each other for quite some time, and he is becoming better and better at sign language, and he is a very fun person to talk to as well. So the two gentlemen, joining me on this panel discussion is quite an honor. So many years before and after World War II, I think that we are embracing times that we could not imagine. Even after the war, there was a strong discrimination against the deaf in society. There were challenges, and many people struggled during these years. And sign language was not accepted. The deaf were a minority, hence sign language was a minority language. And a society gave priority to those that could hear. And there was a sense of discrimination for quite some time. There were strong requests made, but there was a time when sign language itself was prohibited altogether. If we used sign language amongst us, the teachers would scold us, slap our hands, and the same went for family members as well. They just could not understand the importance of sign language. But the deaf put our forces together. We used sign language. We protected sign language, and we handed the baton as well. Sign language is a language. It is something that we need to protect and hand over to the next generation. And we have always kept this in mind throughout our activities at our federation. Sign language is a language, and it is the result of the activities of the deaf as well as the activities of sign language interpreters as well. And we need to take all of this into light as we proceed forward. In 2006, December, at the UN, the Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities was adopted and resolved. So representing the Federation of Deaf, I attended this assembly at the UN, and I listened and observed. And I looked at the proceedings, and I was overwhelmed with emotion. The Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities, there are five articles that pertain to the deaf. Article 2 defines sign language as a language. Article 9, it defines accessibility and the right to accessibility. Article 21,
表現および
This pertains to the freedom of expression and opinion and access to information.
機械のアクセシビリティ、情報へのアクセシビリティ。
Article 24. This covers education. The right to acquire and learn sign language at a young age and the promotion of sign language education is slated in this article. Article 30 covers participation in cultural life, recreation, leisure, and sport.
このような条項が権利条約に規定されました。
So, these articles pertain to the deaf amongst, this convention.
条約の第2条。
Now, Article 2.
意思疎通に関わる定義が盛り込まれました。
The definition of communication has been incorporated andLanguage was defined separately by stating other means. Communication includes languages.
確保というものが規定されています。言語の中では音声言語と対等に手話言語が規定されました。
Sign language is now on equal terms as the oral language. And again, this was clearly stated in Article 2. Here in Japan as well, the ordinance is now adopted, and the Basic Act for Persons with Disabilities has been enacted as well. Article
3 states that
they, in, as possible to choose their language, including sign language.
図を見ていただくと分かるかと思いますが、
Let us, now move on to the diagram, which I believe will clarify what I've just mentioned.
138 年前に遡ります。
138 years ago, I would like to backtrack into history. This is 1880.
イタリアの
in Italy,
ミラノにおきまして、
in Milan,
聴覚障害者教育国際会議が
There was the Milan conference that was hosted. And at this conference, sign language was eliminated from deaf education. In other words, the oral language was promoted.
そして決定されたわけですけれども、手話は排除する。
Eliminating sign language and educate using the verbal oral language was declared on this occasion. Thereafter, the struggle of the deaf began. Now, here in Japan, based on this adoption at the International Conference, the Minister of Education also ordered across the board oral instruction at the National Principals Assembly for Deaf and Blind Schools. So, there has been many activities since then.And now, more and more basic rights are being adopted for persons with disabilities. We can see how times have changed over the years. And 130 years since 1880 at the Vancouver Conference, finally,
the
systematic introduction of sign language as well as Sign language will no longer be eliminated from deaf education was adopted. So this finally came about after 130 years. Regardless where you may be, and here included in Japan as well, we are now seeing sign language being adopted in education. So this is a quick depiction of what we are doing at the Japan Federation of the Deaf in 2010, 8 years ago to be exact.
ロア連盟として手話言語法制定に向けての検討会がスタートしました。
A study group on sign language legislation was established.
研究を重ねて、
And many research and discussion took place.
議論してまいりましたが、先ほども平井知事からのご発言がありましたように、
Governor Hirai just earlier mentioned, the Prefecture of Tottori,
手話言語条例を制定すると、
The Sign Language Act
いう意思のもと、平井知事が率先したリーダーシップを取り、governor took そして全国初、地方選挙条例が制定しました。この成果は歴史的な快挙でもあります。
This was aEpoch-making milestone in history of sign language as well. The governor often says, "This is the revolution of sign language." And he often quotes this.
また北海道の石狩市におきましても、
石狩 city of Hokkaido up north in Japan, 基礎自治体の市レベルで初めて手話言語条例が制定しました。それからあっという間に全国に波及効果があったわけです。Legislation was adopted, and from there onwards, the good word spread.
全国での取り組みというものも広がってきました。初めは条例についてあまり理解をされませんでしたが、徐々にその理解が浸透し、2016年、全国各地、北海道から沖縄にかけて、7市町村、すべて国に対して、手話言語法が必要だという意見書というのを 100%達成するということになりました。全ての自治体で手話言語法に対する制定に向けての 100% 意見書達成。これは快挙です。
Again, this was a milestone. The municipal governments acted towards the government. And since then, there has been momentum throughout Japan. This was something that no other organization was able to do in the past.
全国に手話を広める知事の会が結成され、全国手話言語市区長会も結成され、という新たな全国的な取り組みが始まり、加盟団体も増えました。手話を広める知事の会、各県でも全ての都道府県全てが加盟したということになります。governors are now participating.現在全国各地におきまして手話言語条例がどのような状況になっているか報告申し上げたいと思います。186自治体が手話言語条例を制定しています。道府県レベルは22。
We have 22 prefectures.
それから市区では145。
145 municipalities.
町は
19 towns。
すべて成果をもたらすと思います。これでゴールではありません。
Obviously,
まだまだこれからがスタートです。
We have just started.
条例を制定する自治体が増えていくでしょう。
We know that more and more
滋賀県におきましても、
prefectures will enact this, and I live in Shiga Prefecture, Otsu City, and just this year, October 2nd, we will be adopting this legislation.
このような検討中、また制定する地域も増えてい
くでしょう。 So there are many prefectures, municipalities that are currently considering or are planning to adopt this legislation.
Now,
the social advancement of deaf persons is expanding as well.
今まで、障害者の、社会障壁というものを除去するための推進、
becoming more and more active.
また、ろうあ者と主張、それから地方議員、また行政関係者との密な関係、コミュニケーションを図るような成果が出てきた。平井知事も同様に非常に親しい関係に利用していただいております。
Creating more momentum, and needless to say, Governor Hidai is taking a leading role.
以前と比べて大きく国民的な機運が盛り上がっております。
The demand for legislation of a sign language act is growing stronger day by day.
市区長会もともに国に対して要望し活動を推進しているところです。
as well are also demanding more of the governments as well.
医学の世界におきましても、日本耳鼻咽喉科学会、
the Otorhinolaryngological Society of Japan、
こちらどちらかというと全日本ろうあ連盟とは少し距離のあったところなんですね。ところが、今回、人工内耳をきっかけにしまして。先方から話し合いたいという申し出がありました。隣のおります石橋理事、
も同席いたしました。 And Mr. Ishibashi was in attendance as well on this occasion. 教育文化の委員の担当です。もう石橋理事も頑張って市民工科学会の担当者ともいろいろ議論を積み重ねました。そしてお互いに理解が得たと。そして先方も島田国語についての制定を応援するという、そういうことを公式にもアップしたと。そのような大きな取り組み、展開があります。そのような大きな取り組み、展開があります。So once again, we are seeing another milestone.
私が申し上げたいことは、このタイトルにもありますように、
As my presentation title,implies sign language will change and can change communities, can change individuals and enrich communities and individuals as well. Thank you.
石野理事長、ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much, Mr. 石野。
先ほどから3人のパネリストの方にお話をいただきました。最初に言語学の先生からもお話いただきまして、また平井県知事からは手話言語条例を鳥取県で初めて制定したというお話をいただきました。最後の石野理事長からは全日本ロア連盟の運動の内容について話をしていただきました。この後私から少し質問をさせていただきます。
Like、平
井県知事に、今ですね、手話を広める知事の会ということで、
so、the
全国全都道府県の知事が会に入っていらっしゃるということですが、これからですね、日本の中で手話を広める知事の会の会長として、これから必要なこと、また要望していきたいこととあれば、ぜひお話をお願いいたします。
まず一つは、やはり国の方に、
手話言語法この制定
を求めていく。
Ask the legislation about the sign language as a language. That's the first thing. And also, more important thing is, as Mr. Ishino mentioned,
the
sign language. We need to change society about the sign language and also the way of thinking of people needs to be changed. I think that is important.
So,
All of us need to work together so that we can promote the sign language in the society. We have to think about those social activities. One thing I made a mistake about in my presentation, the Tottori Prefecture is on the right-hand side of Shimane Prefecture. I'm sorry. Well, it could be both.Either side, but in any case, so all over Japan, in the different areas, we would like to promote the sign language, and this is the movement that we would like to start. And I believe that is very important. And as I said, the high school students showing the sign language performance, and they participated in a competition, and they make so much effort.In performance, and it's quite moving.
So
I think that the history will surely change through those activities. And Princess Kako's poem I shared with you, and the young people are working together, collaborating to create those stages. So I think we could understand what they are trying to communicate.
現実にそれをやらなければならない。
So, I think that we need to do that in the reality, and we have to really work together to do so. And today, I think, is the beginning.
みんなで頑張りましょう。
So all of us should really work together.
はい、ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
それでは全日本ろう連盟の
Now from
石野理事長にお
聞きします。手話言語法を目指す。
Mr. Ishino. Now, in pursuit of having the sign language legislation passed,
there are 168 local governments who have the sign language ordinances. Do you think that there will be help? That will be a help? There are two things, two examples I'd like to share with you. One is...Actually, recently in deaf people's convention in Kyushu when I was attending, one of the participants to the conference came up to me and asked for my advice. Actually, she was a hearing person, and she has a daughter about 7 years old. The daughter cannot hear. So, as a mother, she shared with me the pain she has felt. And when the daughter was born, she was hearing, but the daughter lost hearing. And as a parent, very concerned, went to the doctors. According to the doctor, doctor recommended to have an operation to have an artificial hearing device to be built in. And what was told by the doctor is, do not use the sign language. The medical doctor told the mother never to allow the daughter to stop the daughter's use of sign language because the daughter had already started learning and sign language. And so the mother changed the daughter's use of language from sign language to oral language. And but the such a cheerful young girl turned to be very passive and not kind of lost her cheerfulness. And he actually advised the mother to use the sign language, and she regained her cheerfulness and liveliness. And the mother was could not really believe why she was given advice by the medical doctor not to use the sign language. And the JFD was established, founded in Gunma Prefecture in Ikaho. And in fact, they have a memorial for that in that location. And there was a person who brought the photo of the past father, and who was deaf. And when asked why she carried that photo of her father, she responded, he looked forward to the establishment of the foundation, the federation, but had passed away before the establishment. And the daughter and the deaf father had the celebratory New Year's time just by themselves, two of them alone. And in 1 year that the relatives gathered around, and father was very happy and enjoyed drinking sake with the relatives. And seeing her father, she was very happy, and she hadn't seen him that happy for a long time. But unfortunately, her father passed away very soon. The reason why the relatives gathered around for that year was that because of the passing of the sign language ordinance in Tottori Prefecture, that really ordinance changed someone's life like that.
Thank you very much. Now, Professor Maha, you talked about in the area of the linguistics. You used the language, the term language, and the sign language as a language. In comparison to the oral language. And I think you will be talking about the mother tongue, mother language. Yes.
Today,
we listened to a very good, wonderful presentations.
And
the mother tongue, the concept of it was mentioned, I believe. So,
theoretical side
or kind of a complicated and difficult side is something that I'd like to talk about, the relationship between the human being and the mother tongue, which needs to be reconsidered. So sign language, deaf people and hearing people can communicate with each other.
So,
as for the meaning of the mother tongue, we need to clarify the meaning. The mother tongue is a symbolic concept. Mother tongue is a language of your mother. It's not just a simple imitation of the mother's language. And the mother tongue does not have to be single or one.
For me,
I have only one mother, but as for mother tongue, I have two, three, or four. I could have multiple mother tongues. So what is... What are the mother tongues? Whether the language is a mother tongue or not,
it
has to do with the relationship between yourself and the language. Which language gives you your identity? Which language gives you the autonomy or sense of autonomy? Which language, just like you depend on your parents, which language can you depend on? So linguists, for the teachers, you would ask, what is your mother tongue? You cannot ask that question. Because that means that you would lose your freedom and independence if you ask that question to somebody else.
So,
you yourself, what is your mother tongue? It's something that you decide yourself. So, for our mother tongues, let's work together.
はい、ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
それではですね、この後、障害者権利条約、
After this,
またアジアの状況について、
the, regarding the Convention on the Rights of the Persons with Disabilities and Asian situation, I'd like to have Mr. Shimamoto to make some statements. The Regional Director of JFD RSA.
Being the person in charge of the WFD Regional Secretariat for Asia, that was really a wonderful and inspiring discussion that you have. And the messages that you mentioned are appropriate because as we look into deaf people's experiences, there are a lot of concerns growing. And we really need to work hard and to find ways with regards to their education. However, we haven't achieved that much development yet.But in relation to the presentations of Mr. Maher, he mentioned something about sign language. The sign language being at par with oral languages, and that as a deaf person, we really need to work hard in making sure that it is recognized. And secondly, the government should know and should recognize sign languages and should find different means in developing as such and to make sure that there are changes being implemented. And so we have deaf people and hearing people all over the world trying to make certain changes and appropriate changes. And together with the Japan Federation of the Deaf, Mr. Ishino, he mentioned about rights being you know, talking about oppression of rights, and we really have to make sure that the human rights are being observed and that are recognized for each deaf individuals, and that it is very crucial that we need to make sure there are certain support being given to them, especially within the Asian region. We really need to find appropriate ways and come up with activities such as this celebration of International Day of Sign Languages. And yes, this is really very inspiring, and I'm really happy to have this discussion with all of you. And just like what Governor Hirai mentioned, we have to make sure that there will be more and more countries who would be interested in making sure that we try to cooperate and we try to work together with the government and hopefully find a better future for all of us. So thank you very much.
はい、島本理、事務局長ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much, Mr. Shimamoto.
まとめなんですが、
last but not least, let us wrap up. And what was most impressive?Is the sign language can change people. That word resonated within me, and I can empathize with that word. September 23rd is International Sign Languages Day, and again, I believe that we have opened a new chapter in history. Let us work together.
本日は、大変貴重な
Thank you very much, panelists, for your insight today. And on that note, we would like to conclude the discussion. Thank you. Thank you very much once again, the panelists.
Thank you to our wonderful panelists.Thank you to our experts, Mr. John Ma, Mr. Shinji Harai, and Mr. Ishino. And also thank you to our moderator. So we're coming to the end, but we have our sign language poet. He'll be performing for us.So welcome.
も負けず、風にも負けず、雪にも夏の暑さにも負けぬ丈夫な体を持ち、欲はなく決して怒らず、いつも静かに笑っている。一日に玄米四合と味噌と少しの野菜を食べ、あらゆることを自分を感情に入れずによく見聞きし、分かり、そして忘れず、野原の松の林の影の小さなかやぶきの小屋にいて、東に病気の子供あれば行って看病してやり、西に疲れた母あれば行ってその稲の束を追い、南に死にそうな人あれば行って怖がらなくてもいいと言い、北に喧嘩や訴訟があればつまらないからやめろと言い、日照りの時は涙を流し、寒さの夏はおろおろ歩き、みんなにデクノボーと呼ばれ、褒められもせず、苦にもされず、そういうものに私はなりたい。
Thank you so much, Mr. Takashi Suzaki, for that wonderful performance. And also a heartfelt thanks to everyone here today. Thank you for your attendance and for this support. It's been wonderful. We've had a lot of great discussions today, and I think from here on it's important that we all go home and promote sign language wherever we're from. It's very important.And future lives will be changed because of sign language. And that's what we hope for. We're near the end. But I want to thank all our speakers, moderators, people in attendance, our interpreters, Safe Flight Home, Thank you. Goodbye.